I came back to here at Basford today, 1-1. I'd have took that all day long myself this morning. What was your view on the first half of the game, 1-0 down at half time?
Yeah, it was a difficult one. I thought, you know, their shape a little bit caused us a bit of problems. But, you know, we tried to stay compact and it was just a bit bitty, really. I think they did have majority of the ball, but without really causing us too much problems. But obviously one probably mistake, which probably Jono holds his hand up for. It happened, but he did bail us out with a great save on the edge of the box. So, yeah, it was disappointing coming in at 1-0 because I didn't think really, you know, they really threatened our goal, and we had a couple of chances, but again, not really threatening the goalkeeper. So it was disappointing, but you know, the early signs, especially in the first sort of 10 minutes of the game, I could see them tiring already. You know, and the way we were pressing, the way we were trying to be the team that wanted to win it, I thought we were showing right the way through the second half. So
I don't really want to talk about officials, but I thought a linesman, assistant referee, don't really get involved, and then all of a sudden, big decision. Jono definitely dropped it, no argument.
Yeah.
But how he could actually see that it was over the line. Because you didn't have a view, I didn't have a view. But what I'm trying to make the point is the referees normally make the decision. I thought it went against us there with the linesman doing that. Is that how you seen it? Was it frustrating?
Yeah, well, it wasn't a lot. Like you said, it's half one, half a dozen of the others, I suppose, end of the day. Catch it, but yeah, it's disappointing, but we just move on, and that's the good thing about us. You know, we could have wilted and really sort of got upset and, you know, just let them sort of finish us off. We didn't, you know, we stood strong, and you know, it's a good point in the end.
Yeah, I mean, second half we seem to come out with a purpose. Needed to, 1-0 down, you'd had a chat at them half time, corner straight away, and then basically straight back in the game. I don't know what was said at half time, but I think you got a response from the players, whatever was said at half time.
No, we just said it was, you know, there was nothing in the game. You know, we were actually playing well. When we broke on them, we broke well. We created opportunities, so it was a case of more of the same. We just had to be patient at times in terms of our movement and midfielders offering angles to get on the ball. But as soon as the you know, the red card happened, which was rightly so, Tonksy's got a serious gash to his leg, so he's having to go to hospital for stitches. You know, we could fully control the game then, and you know, I was a little bit greedy. I wanted to have the 3 points. So, but there we go.
I think it shows how important a squad is now. With obviously, we know we've got Cuffy out, we know we've got Kenton out, we're obviously maybe going to lose now Tonka because of the cup. We don't know about Marlbon, is that looking serious or is that something for the treatment table tomorrow?
Yeah, he got a heavy kick on his foot, so again, you know, he's struggling at the moment, so that will have to be obviously assessed when he goes back to Stoke. You know, with Cuffy and then having to isolate, and like you say, Kenton with his injury. That is exactly why we need the squad, you know, and to give credit to the boys, you know, Charlie coming on, making a difference. Ben Woods was really positive when he came on, no time, and he had a couple of minutes, but, you know, we've got good players that are coming on and keeping, as I said to you before, the standard of Stafford Rangers team high.
That's great, Matty, thank you very much, and on to Ashton away on Saturday.
Yes, away we go.
Cheers.